like having another tool in your toolbox. You know, you hope you never need it, but, you know, it's there.
Do I remember this correctly? Did you end up having to reload that revolver with you?
No, that was me. That was Fort McNeil. He was wounded in the right hand, and when he tried to reload, he ended up getting a bone fragment and it caught in the cylinder. And when he tried to close the cylinder, on the weapon, he said it wouldn't close. So he said it almost looked like the weapon was bleeding. It didn't function, he tried to go back to the car to get the captain in the back seat, but he was shot a second time at that point.
How many agents died?
Say again?
How many of the FBI agents were killed?
Two out of the eight.
And I just want to point out to people, and we're talking about FBI agents who get a lot of training, who are very good at this stuff. And I always tell people, Ed, just because you're the good guy doesn't mean you can't get shot in the middle of this thing. It doesn't mean you're invincible.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Yeah. There's no guarantee of that at all, like you say, just because you're a good guy doesn't mean you're immune,
Oh, the name of the book is FBI Miami Firefighter. What is it that you want people to know about that, or what is it that you hope this book does?
Well, as you mentioned earlier, Tom, there were so many myths